الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. We continue with كتاب الرقاق, session number 10, and we are still at chapter 6, where الإمام البخاري رحمه الله is directing us to simply only worry about doing acts which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept. He called the chapter بَابُ الْعَمَلِ الَّذِي يُبْتَغَى بِهِ وَجْهُ اللَّهِ. The chapter, the acts or the deeds that Allah's face are seek through, which is in reference to sincerity. You know, sometimes we find في سبيل الله لوجه الله لله. All of these are words which indicate that you must do what you do for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يا إخوة إن الله لا يقبل من العمل إلا ما كان خالصا لوجهه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will only accept from your deeds only the ones that are exclusive for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with no partners. And if the act is ritualistic act, عمل تعبدي يعني, there is another condition for this act to be accepted, which is adherence to the sunnah. Those are the two conditions the scholars come up with in an act of worship for it to be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first condition is sincerity. The second condition is adherence to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم when it came to the salah, صلوا كما رأيتموني أصلي. Pray as you have seen me praying. When he spoke about الوضوء, he said من توضأ نحو وضوئي هذا, whoever makes wudu like me, after he actually demonstrated in front of his companions, Hadith Himran, and Uthman ibn Affan actually himself did the same thing in front of his companions, Uthman yani, and he said the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam did that. He made wudu in front of us, and then he said, whoever makes wudu the way that I did it, or close to it, wasaq al-hadith. Once it came to Hajj, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم خذوا عني مناسككم, learn your rituals after me. So الشاهد, or the important thing is الإمام البخاري is telling you it doesn't matter how long you live, 60, 70, 80 years, 100 years. What matters is the quality of the acts. And for the act to be accepted, it has to be for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he mentioned sincerity. Subhanallah, ikhwah, in this context, we should say that the first Muslims, I say Muslims, who will be the thrown in hell from this ummah, not a thief, not a fornicator, zaniyan, Guess what? Subhanallah, the first people who will be called to account for reckoning in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a scholar. واللفظ الآخر حافظ القرآن. Someone who memorized the Quran. The second one, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, حديث أبي هريرة عند مسلم, رجل جواد, a giver. And the third one, someone who died in the battlefield, شهيد يعني, in the eyes of the beholders. The first people who will be called to reckoning from the Muslims. الحديث هذا يا إخوة له طريق, a predecessor whose name is Shafi ibn Mati' al-Himyari. A predecessor is someone from the second best generation. We call them the students of the companions. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم praised for us how many generations. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, خير الناس قرني, the best of the Muslims are those who lived at my time. Meaning what? Meaning what? The Sahaba, his companions. ثم الذين يلونهم, then those who followed them, meaning the students of the Sahaba. Well, the Sahaba, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, go and convey, they started teaching the deen, passing on the deen. He said, بلغوا ليبلغ الشاهد منكم الغائب, let the one who is present convey to the one who is absent. الصحابة immediately started narrating and sharing what they learned from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We call those the students of the companions. And التابعين, or the students of the companions themselves also, they knew the value and the preciousness and the great reward in conveying the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They also convey it to the third best generation. After that, the fitna got into the ummah. That's why we try to take our deen from those three generations. Understanding and application. فشفي بن ماتع الحميري is a predecessor. He said, أتيت المدينة. I came to المدينة. He came from Himyar, a place in the Arabian, close to Yemen, in order to learn hadith النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. And from a distance, I saw an old man with a huge beard sitting, and the people are surrounding him, and he's narrating the hadith to them. So after he finished, the people dispersed. فَإِذَا هُوَ أَبُو هُرَيْرَةَ, it was Abu Huraira. Abu Huraira, ikhwa, has a status in the ummah out of this world. You know, Abu Huraira became a Muslim only 5 years before the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In spite of this, he is number one narrator of the hadith. Just the authentic ones, 5,000 plus. To the extent that he would teach this, pass this on to the predecessors, and some of the companions who were Muslims for a long time before him, they would say, Abu Huraira, where Abu Huraira gets that stuff from? And then Abu Huraira would come and look at them and say, listen, you guys were busy selling and buying. I did not leave the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam those 5 years. I did not even go to work. I just dedicated my time to the knowledge of the deen. For like he dedicated the time to learn, See, it's important to pass that knowledge on. He dedicated the time to teach as well. So Shafi said to him, listen, I came all the way from Himyar, a faraway place, to hear the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So he said to him, حدثني حديثا. By Allah, narrate to me a hadith. حدثك به رسول الله. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam narrated it to you. And give me something special. So he said to him, come with me. And they sat in a house and he said to him, لأحدثنك حديثا حدثني به رسول الله في هذا الموضع. I will narrate to you a hadith the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم narrated to me in this place. ليس معي أحد غيره. Only both of us were in that place. شوف هذه. فشهق شهقه. Then he fainted. Abu Huraira fainted. He lost his consciousness. So Shafi'i brought some water, sprinkled on him. He wakened up again. And he said to him, I will narrate to you a hadith that no one else heard except me in that place from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then shahaqa shahqa shahqa fainted again. Shafi ibn Mata' waked him for the third time and he started narrating. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِذَا كَانَ يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ, when the day of resurrection is here, تَرَى كُلَّ أُمَّةٍ جَاثِيَةٍ, you will see people kneeling in the land of gathering, on their knees in the land of gathering. ثم يأتي الله, then Allah will come in a way that suits His Majesty, ليقضي بين الخلائق يوم القيامة, to call everyone to account in the day of reckoning. فينادى على حافظ للقرآن ورجل جواد ورجل قاتل فقتل. Then a hafiz will be called, a giving man will be called, and someone who fought in the battlefield and he was killed. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will address the hafiz. Qala, he will say to him, Mada amilta بما علمتك ما أنزلت على رسولي. I taught you what I have revealed to my messenger. What did you do with it? Then the hafiz or the alim will say, O Allah, I did not leave a chance to teach it, but I taught it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to him, كذبت, you are lying. عملت ليقال وقد قيل. When you were teaching it, when you were sharing it, your intention is to get the fame, for the people to know you as a scholar, as a learned person. You seek the dunya through this. And you know what? People spoke about you. وقد قيل. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command the angels to drag that person on his face to hell. Imagine. And this is why, by the way, Abu Hurairah fainted. Because I want to tell you something. Never count yourself out. You have to always question your intentions. The one who is not secure, or the one who does not accuse himself of hypocrisy, is not secure from hypocrisy. So actually you have to question yourself all the time. Shirk ya ikhwa, imagine Nabiullah Ibrahim, I call him the king of monotheism, makes this dua, وَجْنُبْنِي وَبَنِيَّ أَنْ نَعْبُدَ الْأَصْنَامِ. عبادة الأصنام شرك أكبر. Oh Allah, protect me and my offspring from worshipping idols. شرك أكبر. والرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم used to make this دعاء, اللهم إني أعوذ بك أن أشرك بك وأنا أعلم وأستغفرك مما لا أعلم. Oh Allah, I ask your refuge, I seek refuge with you from committing shirk knowingly, and oh Allah, forgive me for the shirk that I committed unknowingly. And this is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when he got on his camel to perform Hajj, the dua that he says, Allahumma hajja la riya'a fiha wa la sum'a. Oh Allah, hajja, that I'm not seeking to gain a reputation through it or to be known. But you have to question. You see, ما أمن النفاق إلا منافق. هذا قول الحسن البصري. The one who feels secure from hypocrisy is the hypocrite. But the one who always question his intention, question himself, is the one, inshallah, by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will be secure from it. This is the reason why Abu Huraira fainted. Because Abu Huraira, when he accepted Islam, or since he accepted Islam, he given his life to that deen, to the knowledge, whether learning it or whether teaching it, until he passed away, until he died. But now imagine this hadith could apply to him. Just for you to know how the companions themselves feared shirk or hypocrisy on themselves. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we know that he shared the names of the hypocrites in the ummah with a companion whose name is Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman radiyallahu anhu. Imagine Umar ibn al-Khattab, one day he said to him, Billahi alayka ya Hudhayfa, I ask you by Allah, O Hudhayfa, is my name on that list? He said, no, and I will never reveal Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam secrets afterwards if I'm asked again. ولذلك يا إخوة الصحابة, the companions after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when there is a janazah, they would look for Hudhayfa, if Hudhayfa is in the janazah or not. Because Hudhayfa was given these names. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam shared with him these names. فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى الإخلاص. سبحان الله, the one who recited the Quran sincerely, له بكل حرف, every letter that you recite is what? حسنة. والحسنة is automatically multiplied to 10 حسنات. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, الماهر بالقرآن, the one who is professional or eloquent with the Quran, reciting the Quran, مع السفرة الكرام البررة, he will be in the company of the nobles of the angels in the day of resurrection. But this is, what is the difference between this one and those sincerity? They did not do this sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, a giving person, الرجل الجواد, I given you all the money, what did you do with it? Ya Rab, I spent it in your cause. Oh, you did this to be known. And guess what people spoke? عملت ليقال وقد قيل. And he also will be dragged in hell. Imagine someone who given, the third one, someone who given his life. Given his life. Killed in the battlefield. You were killed, or you fought in order for the people to say that you are courageous. رجل شجاع. فالشاهد or the important thing in closing يا إخوة, the most important condition is sincerity. Now we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us sincerity. Now when we narrate this hadith, when we narrate this hadith in particular, a lot of us become fearful that maybe I'm coming to the masjid to pray to be known of. Maybe I'm giving my sadaqah because of this. La ya ikhwan. The message that we get from this hadith is always question yourself before you do the act. Always. As a matter of fact, you should strive. You should strive to do as much, inshallah, but just watch your intention. In closing, they say before you do any act, ask yourself, why I'm doing this act? لِمَنْ أَعْمَلْ. The second question, how should I act? If this act is ritualistic, then I will do it according to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Well, Ibn Rajab, ya ikhwa, يعني, allow me 2 more minutes. Kalam fi hadha al-mawdu. He has made a beautiful research in this subject. And he said, listen, if the origin of the act you're sincere, let's say that you came to the masjid and your intention is to pray and worship Allah, sincerity. And then while you're praying, you spotted somebody maybe who's watching you, and then, oh, he's watching me, so let me what? He said, as long as the origin of the act is sincerity, inshallah, it will be accepted. But this person needs to fight that feeling during the act. During the act, you should fight the feeling. You should dismiss showing after, astaghfirullah, you know, and just focus on and doing the act for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if you entertain the showing off, the feeling of showing off, then you decrease of the reward, or the reward is decreased according to how long you entertained it and how long did this take from your salah. And that is why Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says some of us will pray and we come out with 10th, 9th, 8th, 7th, 5th, 6th, We come, we don't receive the whole reward because of that. طيب. But if the origin of the act is showing off, then the act is what? Invalid. إنما الأعمال بالنيات. The intention, and you put on the intention sincerity. فالإمام البخاري in this chapter again is directing you to العمل الذي يبتغى به وجه الله, the act which you should seek the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with it. And inshallah we'll have one more session on this chapter بإذن الله تعالى. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك, والحمد لله رب العالمين.